Recently, I've published a Chrome extension that abuses trusted types to find DOMXSS. It works by locking all the calls to dangerous things. In this video, I'm gonna talk about how to actually use it. If you haven't installed it, you can download it using the link in the description. First of all, you should keep DevTools open, otherwise it'll miss some information. So you navigate to a web page you want to inspect, and the extension will start generating log messages. Each message contains three pieces of information: the sync, the DOM change, and the stack trace. A sync is a code pattern that could run arbitrary JavaScript code if the inputs are malicious. It can be a function or assignment like in HTML. Next is what was changed in the DOM. If we controlled the change, we would have a DOMXSS. How do we investigate it? We check the stack trace, which records the lifecycle of the sync from start to finish. The goal of finding DOMXSS is to identify which sync contains user inputs, also known as the source. Let's use Google's firing range as an example, where they have a bunch of simple DOMXSS testbeds. Untrusted Types has logged two syncs here. Let's look at this one. The stack trace here shows the path of how eval was triggered, starting from bottom to top. We can see setTimeout was called, then trigger, and finally eval. The other sync is similar except it doesn't involve setTimeout. Now we look at how the variable payload was passed. Press Ctrl D to find the next occurrence. So it comes from calling the function lookupCookie. We can press Ctrl+P, then type @lookupCookie, and DevTools will automatically identify and jump to the function's definition. So this function simply reads cookie by the cookie name. We can assign a bad cookie here to test. Hit refresh, and boom. Let's look at a more complicated example. This time we'll use prompt.ml. You don't really need any tools for this challenge, but it's just for demonstration. Here we see more syncs than the previous example. Interacting with the page will generate more log messages. We could go through them one by one, but most of them don't really involve user inputs, but rather static strings. In fact, they are called by jQuery to check browser compatibility. In a real website, you may probably observe a ton of irrelevant syncs, and it's not always obvious which one is vulnerable unless you start looking at the stack trace for each of them. Now think about it. There is only one user input. Wouldn't it be more efficient if we only look for syncs that reflect it? Untrusted Types supports this method. You can use the string DOMXSS with a 0 instead of O in every possible source, then all syncs that contain this string will be highlighted. You can then only focus on these syncs. Start typing different characters, see what is filtered, how it's filtered, and whatnot. It's as simple as that. Leave a comment if you have any questions. Also, subscribe so you get notified when my DevTools course comes out. It'll teach you how to use DevTools as a security tool in both offense and defense perspective.